Song is titled McGinty at the Living Picture, sung by Mr. Dan W. Quinn for the Columbia Phonograph Company of New York and Paris. Dan McGinty went into the TV show with his old wife Mary Ann. He took a front seat in the middle line among the bald-headed clan, but he wasn't prepared for the sights that he saw that nearly knocked him dead. When the living picture came to view, he completely lost his head. When he saw the sleeping beauty with a full round shape, we thought that he would daffy, he was grinning like an ape. He danced and he pranced, and he says, "I've been to France, but that's the warmest thing that ever I saw." And his eyes were down, and loudly he did shout, "The gallery boy hollered for that Lulu out." He ran up like a deer, and he nearly bit the ear off the lady who was doing the living picture. When the girl did see this, with her palm that fine, he said, "I've seen it first, and be the power that's mine." Then up blew his hair, and he got up in his chair, and hollered, "Mary Ann, I'd have to shake you." When he saw the lady bather, he went that mad, a funny feeling tickled every rib that he had. He shouted with a vim, "Oh, I'd like to take a swim with the lady bathers in the living picture." When he saw the other picture, we thought he was gone. Was that a brandy with her summer clothes on? He hollered, "Mary dear, why did you bring me here? I can never love you now the way I used to." Then he looked at Mother Eve, and loudly he did fall. "Your chin will be frost, and the leaves begin to fall." The ushers grabbed him night, put him on a cake of ice, just to keep him cool around the living picture. And he leaped and he creeped, and he took another peep. The way he carried on made the audience weep. His wife said to Dan, "You come home like a man. If you must have living pictures, I will do them." But he didn't hear it speak. He was off in a span, standing on a chair, doing the hootsie-cootsie dance. When the fat girl posed, they had to turn the hose on Wiggity when he saw the living pictures.